Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Some of college football's immortals have played for both Notre Dame and Stanford. Fitting as the Fighting Irish and the Cardinal are on the field in the final moments before kickoff, that this rivalry game is the battle for the Legends Trophy. We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
Teams can't stand each other. This should be a very hard-hitting affair. And now let's head down to the coin toss. Brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep to open up the ball game. Here we go, folks. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 26-yard line. Final game for these seniors on their home field. Some will get to the next level and play some more football. Others, they'll be putting the helmet on for the final time. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Cody's in a running here for a prestigious award, Herbie, but he doesn't want to think about that right now. He's got to stay focused and keep the task at hand in front of him, and that's winning the ball game. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They come out in a goal line set. Tackled after a decent pickup. So the halfback picks up around 4 on the play.
A little bit of over-pursuit by the defense gave him the room he needed to get the first.
Nice run up the middle. Cody picks up about 4 yards on the play. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on their own 41. He's taken down at the 50-yard line.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Brought down at the 39. Makes it out to about the 37-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and 9.
Here's the 8th play of the series. Zips it to the tight end, and down he goes at the 27. From the 27-yard line, first down. The halfback. They'll bring him down at the 29.
It's a great play by the defense, but you know, it really makes you wonder, was there a miscommunication up front by the offensive line? They just seemed to allow the defensive line to get through, and the running back didn't have much of a chance at all.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Deep ball, laying it out there. Third down now. They need to get it to the 17.
34's the mic. 34's the mic. He's coming. Check him. Check him.
Ready. He flings it. This one is incomplete.
The receiver needed to get a step or two further into his route to have any chance of snagging that pass.
The 17-yard line. Big stop by the defense. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Under pressure, and he throws it away. From their own 17-yard line, second down. Here's a screen pass, gets it to the back. He's to the 40. Tackle made around the 47-yard line.
That's just a well-executed screen pass. They had the blockers in front, and they got it to him with room to run.
By 56, by 56.
Got a man tackled for a loss. We've got a second and 14. Ball on the 43-yard line. Quick pass going back to his running back. Tackle around the 48-yard line. Complete. He's got space to work. Knocked out of bounds at about the 37-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Jack on the handoff. Jack gained 7 yards on that play.
That'll make it second and 4.
Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. Yeah, this play is number 8 on the drive. And he just gets rid of it. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Great stand by the defense, and they get it back for their offense. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Just throws this one away. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. Taken down around the 38-yard line. We've played one quarter. No score here. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. The stop at the 40.
Just a good showing on all three downs by the defense. That should fire them up.
So they're going to review this and try to determine exactly where the ball should be spotted down.
I didn't see anything in particular that would make the coach want to challenge this, but he must have seen something to want to review this one.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after the review, they reverse the call on the field. From their own 41-yard line, it's first down. Gains his way to midfield.
That brings in second and one.
Fights forward to around midfield. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
Nice play here by the senior to make the sure tackle. It's not very often that someone's able to shake this guy.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Mike 56.
Makes it to the 41. Second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. And a quick throw. He's taken down at the 26. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 26. Runs it and tackled in the backfield.
That brings up third and 10.
It's the 11th play of the drive. Tailback on the screen. And he shoved out of bounds at the 13-yard line. From the 13-yard line, first down. They failed out here the last two times. He gets out to about the 12-yard line.
Second and nine.
13th play of the drive coming up.
Three down. Mike 34, Mike
scores.
Boy, he looked determined running the football. Nobody was going to keep him out of the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. A 12-play, 68-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. Bryant is lined up to kick this one off. He makes it to the 32-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He's got it with room to run. He's tackled at the 36.
So they get about 4 yards from play action. Notre Dame just took their first timeout.
Second down and six. Ball on the 36-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Mike 56, Mike 56.
And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
From their own 42-yard line, second down. Got a man. Watch out here. That's a great tackle at the 48.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. Third down.
Gross falling back and got his man. Brought down at about the 29-yard line.
Stevens is a tackle at the 29-yard line. First down.
You don't see me in your nightmare, son. You don't see me in your nightmare. Mike 56.
Makes the catch and look out. Brought down in the open field. Notre Dame's going to have to use their second timeout of the half. From the 19-yard line. First down.
Mike 56, Mike 56. Out. Ben Boston. Ben Boston.
Throws and it's incomplete.
You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open. And everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, throw it. And you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, he aimed the ball. It was incomplete.
Gets out to around the 9.
That'll bring up 3rd and inches.
Mike 56, Mike 56. Blue 14, Blue 14.
He makes it out to maybe the 7-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards.
That
makes it first and goal.
Texas. 36, 36. Texas. Down. Oklahoma.
Throws it. Watch out. Oh, almost had a pick.
This guy's got to just feel awful dropping an easy interception in the end zone. The best thing that he could do now is go to his teammates and hope that they're able to get him back up and get ready to play that next play.
To about the 5-yard line. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game.
splits the uprights with the extra point. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Checking out the action in Cincinnati. This game was tighter than spandex on a sumo wrestler. The Bearcats take it by 5.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. Thornton has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. And he'll return this one from the 7th. And he's taken down at the 30. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail-biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He's hit before it can go anywhere. Excellent play as a quarterback found his receiver for a big game.
Well, give credit here to the receiver for finding that seam and coming up with a nice game for the offense.
From the 49-yard line, it's first down. He sails it long. And it's picked off. It's the safety. He tried to force that one in there.
Yep. And the safety made him pay for it. Great job of watching the quarterback's eyes and even a better catch.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45. Catch downfield, and down he goes at the 19-yard line. We've played a half of football. We're even at 7 in this one.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here? Got a good, well, a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. You got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. Yeah. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. They stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. They come out of an empty backfield. Quick pass. He gets hit out of bounds at the 37.
That makes it second and 2.
5 guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Out of bounds, right around the 40.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. First down.
The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a 5-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Steps out of bounds at the 41.
That brings us second and
Jones around the 45-yard line. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look.
Excellent job here by the defense to sniff that one out before it turned into a first down.
It's a short kick. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. Cody gains about 2 yards on the run.
That makes it second and eight.
From their own 35-yard line. Second down. They're packed in tight on the line. Up the middle for a nice game.
That makes it third and three.
Tackle at the 48-yard line. From their own 48-yard line. First down. Nice run to the outside. About the 45.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. Third down.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down.
Three down. Mike 56.
Here we go. Run.
And they'll still be a little short of the first down line.
Well, they get some positive yards, but this defensive line really busted through and broke that play up.
Well, Kirk, we saw this kid head to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, and now we see he's back on the sideline. That's good news. Looks like he should be able to get back in the action. They'll bring him down to the 38-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. They line up in the jumbo set. He's tackled at the 37-yard line.
That's a good gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and nine.
Second and nine coming up here. Ball on the 37-yard line. And he's taken down at the 36-yard line.
Gain of one on the play. That'll bring up third and eight.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. He's looking for six. This one will fall incomplete.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers. So that was a really good effort.
Well, folks, fourth down again, and it looks like they're going to go for it again. Going for it all to the end zone. Through his hands. The defense holds, and the ball will change hands. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. And they'll get him in the backfield.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
So at the end of three, we get a tie game at 7-7. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. He steps out at the 38.
Call it again in 5 yards. Third down.
Big stop there early in the fourth quarter, and the way this game has been played and how tight it's been, every defensive stop will be huge. Fourth and long here after the sack. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. Well, the defenses have certainly been the story in this one.
The defense are playing great. I might recommend dropping down a level or two. Instead of playing at the higher level, go down to the freshman level and give yourself a chance to execute a little bit better.
We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Makes his way to about the 38. From the 38-yard line, first down. Here's an opening. Looking for the corner. He's taken down around the 29-yard line. Out in a goal line set. Cunningham on the handoff. And a nice run by the tailback.
Not a lot of razzle-dazzle here, but it gets the job done and picks up the first down.
From the 25-yard line, it's first down. Nice run there. Cunningham gets 7 yards on the play.
Pay for bringing both outside linebackers. That's composure right there.
Tied up here in the fourth. Now would be the time for a goal line stand. And they make the stop
at about the 5-yard line.
A 2-yard run by the halfback.
And he's brought down there by the senior at linebacker. That won't be the last time today we'll be talking about this young man.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Fires on play action, touchdown! And he tacks on the extra point. A 7-play, 53-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. So our score, 14-7. Ryan looks ready to kick this one off. And He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Notre Dame's been unable to really show that they're the team to beat here, but it looks like they're going to get another chance at it.
Well, it's now or never. This team has put themselves in a position where they have to hope for some heroics late. It's because they played sloppy most of the game. They're very fortunate they still have a chance to be able to win this game.
Goes to his back, and it's in and out of his hands. From their own 26-yard line, second down. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
That's good for a gain of 19 yards. First down.
He's out of bounds. 18 yards. First down. Here we go. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
That's good for a gain of 17 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. Notre Dame to kick this one off. Sanders from the four. He's got the corner. He's knocked out of bounds at the 33. Here we are late in the fourth quarter, and this is what this game has come down to. Every possession's going to count, and this could be the one right here. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He's tackled at about the 47-yard line. Ball on the 40-yard line. pressure coming. And that sets them up for a first and goal.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz coming.
And they're going to take a timeout here and let him think about it. Just to get him to think a little more about it, they're going to call a timeout. Folks, we're either going to see victory with this field goal or overtime. Here we go. There's the timeout we were all expecting. The kick is up, and he's got it. If they field the kick here, a touchdown return is their only chance at victory. Knocked out of bounds at about the 29-yard line. Going to do it for this one. Our final score, 17-14, Cardinals. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action of this one?
They've talked about the rivalry all week long, and for good reason. We saw the intensity down on the field every play, and it showed us why these teams love to hate each other. It'll be interesting to see how this game carries over to the next time they play.
Going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.